now to our ongoing coverage of schools in crisis. Top education leaders in Massachusetts have a problem with admission policies at some of the local vocational schools.
They say they're not diverse enough. Now a city leader is saying it could be a civil rights issue. NBC 10's Ashley Cullinane is here with the school's response. Ashley?
In the 6 letters I obtained, the state claims career vocational technical schools aren't admitting enough students with disabilities, low-income students, students of color, and English language learners. The 2 local schools involved, Greater New Bedford Vocational Technical High School and Diman Regional Vocational Technical High School in Fall River.
Letters sent out by Massachusetts Education Commissioner Jeffrey Riley call attention to staggering statistics in local vocational schools. According to state data, last school year, New Bedford High School had around 10 times more English language learners than did Greater New Bedford Voc-Tech. The student population at Voc-Tech was also predominantly white, whereas New Bedford High was predominantly Hispanic. The case similar in Fall River at Diman Regional Voc-Tech.
Do you believe that Greater New Bedford Voc-Tech has any policies in its admissions process that limits the equal access to students?
Absolutely not.
This is Greater New Bedford Voc-Tech Superintendent James O'Brien. He says applications are weighted by the following: 30% attendance, 30% discipline, 30% grades, and 10% guidance counselor recommendations. Diamond's admissions process is similar, but with more weight put on grades.
It's not that we don't accept students of a diverse population. Without access into the school, middle school programs, they don't know about the school, so how can they apply?
New Bedford Mayor John Mitchell says he, public school educators, and civil rights leaders across the state have long raised concerns about the admissions policies. He wrote, all students who could benefit from a vocational education should have a fair chance at getting in. But as Desi's letter confirms, this isn't happening. O'Brien said he's willing to work with the state to tweak percentages and make sure everyone has an equal shot.
We welcome the review from the commissioner.
Fairhaven Public School Superintendent Robert Baldwin called admissions policies a culture of competitive recruitment practices, and he told me he believes there is a workforce pipeline crisis and it has become tremendously difficult for all middle school students to get into regional vocational schools. Meanwhile, O'Brien added he'd be happy to expand the school if Greater New Bedford Voc-Tech received the funding. Both he and Diman leaders say state education officials have visited them and are willing to find a solution. In the studio, Ashley Cullinane, NBC 10 News.
All right.